Hello there, cutie. How are you today? And what brings you to the Favonius Library? I see. Returning a book, are we? Well, let's see it. I hope, for your sake, that it's on time. I'm kidding, of course. If it was late, I would know. Ah, yes. Everything seems to be in order. So, cutie, what are you doing right now? Are you busy? Well, I was simply wondering, since you're here and all, if you'd like to have a cup of tea with me. I would love that. You see, it does get rather lonely here sometimes. With everyone so busy milling about all over Mondstadt, I sometimes find myself a little too alone. With too much time on my hands, I can't help but get a little bored, even when I'm surrounded by all of these incredible texts. So, what do you say? Keep me some company, cutie. Wonderful. So, why don't you regale me with stories of your travels. I think that might be fun. Oh, you're being coy. You don't need to hear about me. Well, I simply while away my time here in the library. Well, of course, things can get a little more complicated when someone borrows a book for a bit too long. You've seen me in action, though. I know you have. Well, consider yourself lucky. Not many live to see it and tell the tale. I'm kidding, of course. Now, more about you. How have you been doing since your return to the city? That's good. Has everyone been appropriately friendly? That's good to hear. How long has it been, traveler, since I've last seen you? Since you've last put aside the time for little old me? Of course, I suppose I could do the same for you. Just come with you on a journey or two. I think that might be nice. What about you? Would you deign to have me? I could be of use, of course, with my knowledge of the arcane arts. You'd be surprised what tricks I have up my sleeve. After all, I was the Sumeru Academia's most powerful student in 200 years. And that's not for nothing. They don't give that title to just anyone. Oh, well, I've left that life behind. The price to pay for that kind of knowledge was something I could not afford at the time. Plus, my life here with the Knights of Favonius is much more harmonious, you might say. Now, I'm sure your travels haven't been perfectly smooth. I'm sure you have not met your match yet. I see some fatigue in your weary eyes. You have not gotten sufficient rest, have you? Oh, and your face. It seems you've been pushed around a bit, haven't you? Battered and bruised by an errant hilly churl here or there. Would it be all right if I took a closer look at you? Oh, thank you, Traveler. Let's see. Your face is so tired. But make sure you're in tip-top form for me, won't you? If you wouldn't mind. We should spend more time together like this, I think. It might be good for the both of us. Much more vast than the one here in Mondstadt. And I would hate to see it not being properly taken care of. If you ever need someone to help you with this upkeep, I'd be more than happy to volunteer. What do you think about that, my cutie? Now, drink your tea, darling, and relax. Relax. I don't want you getting ill now. Relax your body. Work. Some of it rather unnecessary in my opinion, but I respect her, so I do my part. And you do so much for all of us. So please, let us do something for you too. It's very important. Time with friends and family. After all, I'd say Mondstadt is both of those things to you since you began your journey. fills me with a great sense of pride. Continue to see you grow, traveler. Your beauty is truly beyond the reaches of this world. Well, I don't mean to take up too much of your time. I just wanted to make sure that you were remembering to do the important things, like, for example, take care of yourself, and, of course, give me some attention. I do love your attention. You look rather sleepy. Or you might take a very relaxing nap. I'll join you if you'd like. We can sleep together. Oh, you know what I mean, darling. Unless... I'm kidding, of course. I'm on the clock. No. Would you like to take more breaks like this with me in the future? Shh, it's alright. This library is nice and quiet. The perfect place to get away from it all for the time being. Don't you think? No, all of your worries. Can read each other's stories. I'll share with you my favorite book I found in this library, and you can share with me your travels to Liyue, to Inazuma, Sumeru, Fontaine, Natlan, Shinasnaya, and perhaps the fabled Gonria, and even beyond this world. You fascinate me, thinking about all these amazing journeys. Perhaps I should have been a traveler too, but I simply don't have the patience for it. And one thing you might have noticed about me is I am rather lazy. You're right. I should use more negligible language when referring to my laziness, but it is what it is. After all, I've poured enough of myself into my work that I don't think I could. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm rambling. Sometimes I get lost in the past, as I'm sure you. Now, why don't you close those tired eyes for me, and I'll fix you up another cup of tea for when you wake. You'll have plenty of time in the day to finish your tasks, your daily commissions. But for now, why don't you just sit here with me and let all your worries fade away into the share your burden with you.